audio. A movie in your mind.
Graphic Audio presents Archie Comics, Jughead, The Hunger, Volume 3. Written by Frank Tieri. Adapted and directed by Eric Messner with a full cast. Jughead stood with a small group of friends in the cemetery at dusk. He looked down at the grave, trying to hold it together. With tears in his eyes, he somberly reached into his suit coat pocket and pulled out a bone. He stepped forward and laid it on the mound of fresh dirt covering the grave. Just behind the mound was a tombstone that read, "Here lies Hot Dog, man's best friend, and Jughead's, too." He put his hand on the monument to his dog and stood up. In attendance at Hot Dog's funeral were Jughead's family, Archie and his family, Betty, Kevin Keller, Chuck Clayton, Miss Beasley, Midge, and a few others all dressed in black for the funeral. The short funeral service for Hot Dog over, some people shuffled off while others stayed nearby to offer their condolences to Jughead. Archie and his parents stood with him.
"We're so sorry, Jug."
"He was a good dog."
"The best."
"So senseless. I mean, Veronica and Reggie."
Archie's dad put his arm around his wife.
"We saw them, all you kids, grow up."
Archie and Jughead both started to look uncomfortable at the mention of Veronica and Reggie.
"I still can't believe they did this. They're the Riverdale Ripper."
Yeah.
Archie put his hand on Jug's shoulder to break up the conversation.
"Yeah, well, neither can we, Dad. Neither can we.
Now that they're on the run and away from Riverdale, maybe things can finally go back to normal a bit."
"Normal would be good."
Kevin Keller, Chuck Clayton, Midge Klump, and Tony Topaz walked up to the group. Midge was wearing Moose's jacket over her shoulder. Kevin smiled sheepishly.
"And what's more normal than the gang hitting Pops?"
Kevin walked over to Jug and patted him on the back, attempting to cheer up his friend.
"What do you say, Jug? I bet a burger or five will cheer you up a bit."
Well, Kev, maybe five will, yeah."
Kevin, Chuck, and Jughead began to walk towards the entrance of the cemetery. Midge stood still. Tony walked a few steps and stopped. She turned back to Midge.
"Hey, you coming, Midge?"
Midge pulled Moose's coat over her shoulder and looked down.
"Yeah, no, sorry, guys. I'm not really hungry. You guys go on without me."
She turned and walked away from the group.
"I'll catch you all later."
The group turned and watched Midge leave.
"Poor thing. She just can't get over Moose."
"It's hard to believe what happened, you know? I mean, Reggie and Veronica committing all those Riverdale Ripper crimes?"
"Tell me about it, Tony. Really, who would have thought the Riverdale Ripper would have been one of us?"
Jughead stared at the ground, the conversation clearly making him uncomfortable. Then he looked up at the group around him as Betty joined them.
Riverdale Ripper.
In Jughead's mind, his friend's eyes began to take on a yellow glow. All their faces contorted and warped, including Archie's and Betty's. Jughead stepped back from the group. He blinked, and when he looked at his friends again, they were normal. All stared back at him with concern.
"Jug?
You okay?"
Jughead raised a hand to his forehead and closed his eyes for a moment.
"You know what, guys? I'm out too. I'm not hungry either."
Now the group looked shocked. Jughead turned and walked away, his hands in his pockets, head down.
"Did he just say he wasn't hungry?"
"Now I know something's wrong."
Jughead left the cemetery. The group left, too, and none of them saw the tiny figure in a blue hoodie off behind a shed, silently observing them.
"Now I know something's wrong."
A shadowy figure in a lab coat sat staring at a large monitor. It showed the group standing in the cemetery with Jughead slowly walking away.
Wrong, Chuck Clayton. Quite the contrary.
The figure turned toward the bank. He smiled at the large steel door.
For you see...
Suddenly, the large metal door crashed down. Dust flew up into the air. A hulking and dangerous figure with glowing yellow eyes slowly lumbered into the room and stopped.
Something is finally about to be made right.
That night, Archie and Betty walked into Tony's Pizza. They went straight up to the counter, where a frazzled and balding Tony stood.
Where's he at, Tony?
In the back. Two pies with everything on it. A calzone, my mom's ziti, two orders of garlic knots, and three cannolis to wash it down. Oh, that bad, huh?
You have no idea.
The couple headed toward the back. Jughead sat at a table alone. Around him on the table was a half-eaten pizza, a half-eaten order of garlic knots, half a calzone, and an almost gone plate of ziti and half a cannoli. Jughead had a slice of pizza up to his mouth when he saw Betty and Archie. Betty smiled.
So, not hungry, huh?
They sat down across from him.
Meh. I just wanted to get out of there.
Why? Kevin and the guys were just looking to comfort you.
Yeah. Comfort me for stuff that I'm responsible for. You didn't kill Hot Dog or Moose.
Jughead looked depressed.
Didn't I, though? Look, we all know we framed Reggie and Ronnie, and they're not innocent in all this, but the bottom line is, no one in Riverdale would be dead right now if I wasn't a werewolf.
You're right.
Betty.
No, Arch. If we're going to do this, if I'm on board, there'll be no sugarcoating things. Yes, Jug. In an indirect way, and sometimes direct way, you are responsible for all these deaths lately in Riverdale. Hell, it's why I was trying to kill you for all these months.
Yeah. I kind of noticed the trying to kill me part, I have to admit.
So why'd I stop then? Maybe because, yeah, I faced quite a few other werewolves in my time, seen them in action. They take glee in their kills, relish the violence. You don't. They can control their actions in werewolf form. You can't. You came back for your sister when you knew it meant almost certain death. It all means there's still you in there somewhere.
Betty gave him a slight smile.
It's why, you know, I'm not trying to kill you anymore.
Jughead returned the smile.
Thanks, Betty. That means a lot. Especially the not killing me part, but...
Jughead picked his phone up from the table. The caller ID was concerning.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.